Come to the Maine Fiddle Camp old-time variety show. We want you to know that it's time to go and join the Maine Fiddle Camp old-time variety show. Break out that fiddle and bow. There will be music, laughter, bad jokes, and song. You can join in. It's for everyone. Come to the Maine Fiddle Camp old-time variety show. Break out the fiddle and bow. Show. I'm your host and camp director, Doug Protzik, and now I'm going to introduce my co-host, Glenn Loper.
Hey, that's me. Hey, Doug, it's good to be here. We've got a great show lined up, and you know, this is show number 7. I can't believe we've made it all this way. Yeah, 7's a lucky number. I was thinking maybe this is the time when those bad jokes are actually funny. Because it's lucky 7. We should try it. Maybe they're funny.
Maybe. So I got one. All right. What kind of bee can't make up its mind?
I don't know.
A maybe.
Maybe. Doug, this is kind of topical. What's the best flower for a boy to give to his mom on Mother's Day?
Ooh. What's the best flower for a boy to give his mom on Mother's Day? I don't know. I give up.
A sunflower.
Oh, I should have thought of that. You think you're really funny. You think you're a comedian. Hey, tell you what. Why don't cannibals like comedians?
They're salty? I don't know.
They think they taste funny.
it does taste funny. How do sheep celebrate Memorial Day, Doug?
How do sheep celebrate Memorial Day? I give up.
Well, they like to throw up barbecue. Barbecue, BBQ, barbecue. Oh, that was fun. Maybe it was funny. Hey, Doug, what's up with you? You got anything new cooking these days?
Well, I've been having fun playing music with my favorite old-time piano player these days, a Maine Fiddle Camper herself, Louise Strong. Here, let me show you what I mean. When I got to Louise's, right away, she played me one of her favorite foxtrots. Time to play some classic Down East hornpipes. So here's Louise accompanied
Blanchard's and good for the tongue. Time piano playing is the real deal. She was playing for dances as a teenager in Nova Scotia, and so she really absorbed the fiddling and piano tradition.
Yeah, I agree, Doug. Louise is a total gem. Well, next, we have a performance from the never afraid to be awesome Franklin County Fiddlers, led by Maine Fiddle Camp teacher Steve Muse. Coming to us from Farmington, Maine, they're going to be playing a medley of Ukrainian music. Take it away.
Thank you.
All right, fantastic stuff from the Franklin County Fiddlers. Thanks for sharing that. We're all thinking about the terrible struggles that the Ukrainian people are going through right now. Well, we've had a few tunes. How about a song? Pam Weeks, Bill Olson, and Jim Joseph have a great one for us, taken live from a show in Fort Kent, Maine. Here's Tiakadi.
All right, right. Anyway, we would love to have you whistle along with us because it's better to whistle than whine, right? Am I right? Yeah.
And what's their whistling part?
So everybody on three. One, two, three. Beautiful. Come on up here. All right.
You'll get lots of chances to practice that.
So this is actually a sea shanty with some whistling thrown in for good measure. It's called Strike the Bell. Out on the quarterdeck and walking all about, there's a second mate so steady and so stout. What he's a-thinking, he knows not himself, and we're wishing he would hurry up and strike.
Strike the bell, strike the bell, second mate, let us go below. Look around the windward, you can see it's going to blow. Looking at the glass, you can see that it has fell, and we wish that you would hurry up and strike. Strike the bell.
That was great. You'll get a lot more chances, too. Up on the main deck, working at the pumps, there's a starboard watch all longing for their bunks. Off to the windward, they see a great swell, and they're wishing he would hurry up and strike.
Strike the bell, strike the bell, second mate, let us go below. Look out well to windward, you can see it's going to blow. Looking at the glass, you can see that it has fell, and we wish that you would hurry up and strike. Strike the bell.
Aft at the wheel, poor Anderson stands, clutching at the spokes with his cold and mitten hands, a-looking at the compass head, his course is true and well, and he's wishing you would hurry up and strike.
Strike the bell, strike the bell, second mate, let us go below. Look you well to windward, you can see it's going to blow. Looking at the glass, you can see that it has fell, and we wish that you would hurry up and strike. Strike the bell.
Forward on the forecastle head and keeping sharp lookout. There's a Johnny standing all ready for to shout. The lights are burning bright, sir, and everything is well. And we're wishing you would hurry up and strike.
Strike the bell, strike the bell, second mate, let us go below. Look you well to windward, you can see it's going to blow. Looking at the glass, you can see that it has fell. And we wish that you would hurry up and strike. Strike the bell.
On the poop deck, our gallant captain stands, looking to the west with a spyglass in his hands. What he's a-thinking, we know very well. He's a-thinking more of shortening sail than strike.
Strike the bell, second mate, let us go below. Look you well to windward, you can see it's going to blow. Looking at the glass, you can see that it has fell, and we wish that you would hurry up and strike. Strike the bell, second mate, let us go below. Look you well to windward, you can see it's going to blow. Looking at the glass, you can see that it has fell, and we wish that you would hurry up and strike. Strike the bell.
Thanks, Tiakadi. Great harmonies as always. And I know that Doug liked that one too, because he's got a thing for bells. Well, next up, we have a few choice tunes of the Quebecois variety from longtime Maine fiddle camper Paul Fackler. I'll let Paul tell us all about it.
Hello, Maine Fiddle Camp. It will be great to be in person at camp in June this year. Let's keep our fingers crossed. So one of my COVID projects has been to work with the music of a fiddler from the Gaspé Peninsula, from a town called Douglastown. His name was Erskine Morris. And he recorded a lot of his music on reel-to-reel and cassette tapes. And his son has shoeboxes full of them that he has digitized. And I've been going through a lot of that, transcribing it and so forth. And so today I want to play you three tunes from the repertoire of Erskine Morris. These are three tunes that seem like they're old Gaspé tunes. The first one is called Little Boy's Reel. The second one is Grandmother's Reel. And the third one is Eva Trotty's tune. So here we go.
Fiddle Camp, and to celebrate that, we're going to take the Wayback Machine some 80-90 years past and celebrate some of the great ukulele icons of the past and the present.
No, wait, Doug, can I get in on the Wayback Machine? Can I come too?
Oh, sure. Oh, all right. Yeah, I figured out how to do that, Glenn, because first of all, I got to put on my goggles.
Okay.
Let me get those on. Oh, yeah. Now I'm going to put the goggles on you, so get ready, because you need the goggles for the Wayback Machine. So here we go. Okay.
Oh,
hey!
Whoa.
Okay, all right, here we go! Here we go! Whoa.
Never really guessed you'd part at the height of your romance, but something in the air tells me that she don't care.
On a lamp, I know I look just like a tramp, or you may think I'm hanging round to steal a cab. But no, I'm not a crook, and if you think that's what I look, I'll tell you why I'm here and what my motives are. I'm leaning on the lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by. Oh me, oh my, I hope the little lady comes by. I don't know if she'll get away, she doesn't always get away, but anyhow I know that she'll try. Oh me, oh my, I hope the little lady comes by.
Of the screen.
But
now, if you'll just
really
step over here, I know, but I'm sure you like Roy because, you know, he is radio's sensation just now.
All right. one, two, three.
Be happy. Be happy. Be happy. Happy as a foot in a shoe. Happy as a pocket in a kangaroo. Happy as the ink in your tattoo. Happy.
Happy as a coconut in a pie. Happy as a suntan in July. Happy as a sparkle in your eye. I'm happy.
You can be the pillow when I'll be the head.
You can be the jelly. I'll be the bread.
Happy.
Be happy.
Great. Oh, yes. So much better now. Hey, Glenn, are you there? Glenn, did you make it back? Did you make it back, Glenn?
Oh, yeah, Doug, I'm here. Whew. Man. Oh, I made it. Wow, that was totally ukular. Now, it's true that we do love the ukulele at Maine Fiddle Camp, but you know what we also love is a good set of classic New England jigs. And Peter Urensky and Emmeline Den Reynolds are up to deliver just that. They'll play three tunes, the Steamboat Quickstep, Christina's Dream, a Newfoundland tune by Emile Benoit, and wrap things up with the Barber's Jig. Here's Peter and Emmeline.
Thank you.
Great tunes. Thanks, Peter and Emmeline. Well, a few months ago, Ed Perlman treated us with a selection from some of the concerts he's been hosting on his website, fiddleonline.com. And he's put together another great sampler of some fantastic fiddling styles from around the globe. Enjoy. Thank you. Yeah, what a treat. You can find more about those concerts, workshops, and just teaching resources that Ed has to offer at fiddle-online.com. Next up, we'll take a trip down to Tiaskin, Maryland to visit our friends Guinevere, Isabel, and Elijah. Please welcome the Folk Villains.
Villains coming to camp from the front of our fireplace. And today we'll be recording for y'all a tune that I learned from my amazing, wonderful teacher, Mrs. Ellen Dollar, at the winter edition of Virtual Maine Fiddle Camp, which happened about like maybe a month and a half ago, who knows. In between 2 months. More than a month and a half. Okay, anyway. The song is The Accordionist. Shame we don't have an accordion player though. It's silly. Come on, Gwen, get on it. That's not how you play accordion. Close. It's close.
Very close.
Very close. All right, ready? One, two, three.
Thanks, Folk Villains. Yes, we will like and subscribe. Well, I guess I already have a mustache. Well, one thing we haven't quite gotten to this show is Irish music. Maine Fiddle Camp teacher David Stimson said he could help us out. David's been at camp and has taught piano, English concertina, and fiddle, and he plays a few other instruments as well. Hey, David, good to see you. How's it going?
Going pretty well. How are you doing?
Oh, pretty good. Well, I hear you're playing a few tunes on the fiddle for us. What do you have?
Okay, I've got a few Irish tunes. It'll be a hornpipe and two reels. The hornpipe is called the Poll Hey Penny, P-O-L-L, Hey Penny. That tune, Tamara, my wife, got from Martin Hayes in a workshop in Nova Scotia almost 30 years ago. And a little bit different version than what you're used to hearing in sessions. The other two tunes are reels. One is called The Old Bush, and the second one is The New Mown Meadow.
Thank you.
Thanks, David. That was a cool set of tunes. If any of you guitar players are looking for some tunes to keep you on your toes, go back and try playing along with that set. It's a little squirrely. Well, it might be time for another song. Lissa Schneckenberger will treat us with Lovely Jamie. It's a traditional ballad from her 2008 album Song. Here's Lissa.
To welcome Ellen Gawler to the Old Time Variety Show. Welcome, Ellen.
Hey, thanks, Doug. It's so great to be here. It's been so fun to participate in all these shows all year long. You've done a great job putting them together. And we're really looking forward to Maine Fiddle Camp, too, coming right up.
Yeah, Maine Fiddle Camp. Now tell us a little bit about this video that we're going to see of your group, the Pineland Fiddlers, going to the Shetland Islands.
Well, Doug, as you may well know, years ago, I went to Shetland to do an internship and to study the music there. And I stayed with a prominent fiddler named Tommy Anderson at that time and learned from him and helped him teach in the Upper Islands. I was there for 3 months from January to March. It was very dark and cold. And Shetland has such a rich history of fiddling. It's a very unusual place in that way. And so I wanted to return with my students. And so that's what we did. It was nearly 40 years later. It was a huge, wonderful revisiting of this beautiful place.
Well, tell us what you did on your tour to the Shetland Islands.
Well, we planned our trip around attending a festival called the Folk Frenzy. And it was a week-long festival right there in the big city, the small city, I should say, of Lerwick. And the kids were able to attend workshops all day. And there were a couple of opportunities to play. We were included in the big culminating concert at the end of the festival. There were quite a few students. There were 15 kids and 15 parents. And we stayed in youth hostels and Airbnbs. And then at the end of our time there, we took a few days and went up to the upper islands. We went to the very tippity top, to the uppermost rock, where it was a haven for breeding birds, masses and masses of beautiful birds. And then we had a little bit of playing with another youth group in a concert in town just before we left, which people we had met at the festival. And that was really, really fun. So it was a very enriching trip for the kids. They learned a lot of tunes. And so you'll see us playing these tunes. This is a medley of tunes that we learned at the festival. The first one's called Da Oyster. Of course, they say da instead of the, because of the Norwegian influence. And then we go into Da Backreel, Da Bunny Isle of Wolsey, and we finish that with Dale Stick the Minister, or Devil Stick the Minister. So I hope you enjoy it.
Well, Alan, before we see the video, tell us a little bit about the Viking scene that's in it.
Oh my gosh, yeah, we just happened upon a Viking parade. It was a Midsummer's festival. They celebrate the seasons. In fact, when I first arrived in Shetland, it was just before a big festival called Upheliya, where they build a big Viking effigy of a Viking ship, and they put it in the center of town, and these groups of Vikings, all, you know, these almost like Elks Club, they're called geyser clubs. They dress up and they bring torches and they march into town and they circle the Viking ship and they throw the torches in and the whole thing burns up. And it's a very ancient tradition of the return of the sun. So there you'll see this alive and well Viking tradition and celebration on Midsummer's night.
All right. Well, thanks for the contribution, Ellen. So here we go with the video.
Thank you.
Oh man, what great music and what a great experience for all those young players. That was great. Well, man, I can't believe it. We've kind of made it to the end of the show. We should bring back Doug. Hey, Doug, are you out there?
Oh, Glenn, it's great to be back. And I've really enjoyed watching the show. So I want to thank all the performers for contributing. And I guess we've got one more show coming up.
That's right. June 11th will be number 8 in kind of our last virtual variety show for a while. And then I think we've got some real camp after that. Right, Doug?
Yes, Glenn, it's very exciting. We are going right ahead and having real Maine Fiddle Camp this summer, starting with our traditional Father's Day weekend in June 17th, and followed by our traditional June week, and then also a couple of weeks in August, all at our new location at Pilgrim Lodge. It's all very exciting. We're going to proceed ahead in the safest possible manner. So all the information is on our website. So please check that out and sign up for our mailing list as well.
Wow, that's exciting. I can't wait for real camp. But it is time for the tradition at the end of the variety show. We always end with a lullaby. Doug, what do we have tonight?
Oh, we've got Katie Newell celebrating her daughter Helen's graduation from Berklee School of Music, and at her place singing one of my favorite songs of this time of year by my request. So it's time to end the show, everybody, with the traditional Maine Fiddle Camp lullaby. So thanks for watching, and goodbye, everybody.
Yeah, everyone's ready.
Yeah,
everyone's ready. Yep. Two, ready. But I heard a red-winged blackbird, red-winged blackbird down the road. But I heard a red-winged blackbird, red-winged blackbird down my road.
He'll be there beside the river when the winter finally breaks his bones. He'll be king among the rushes. He'll be master of his home.
But I heard a red-winged blackbird, red-winged blackbird down my road. But I heard a red-winged blackbird, red-winged blackbird down my road.
Safe as Moses in the rushes, built his home by the river wide. Every time I hear him singing, makes me feel like spring inside.
But I heard a red-winged blackbird, red-winged blackbird down my road. But I heard a red-winged blackbird, red-winged blackbird down my road.
He'll be in there singing his heart out. He'll be telling me stories too of where he went to winter last year.
But I heard